As a kid, I was always fascinated with history. I read about it, I watched documentaries, but now I want to visit and walk the ground of those historic places that I've spent years studying. Join me on my trek, History Adventures. Since the Revolutionary War, the idea of a Medal for Valor has been discussed. It wasn't until the American Civil War that Congress passed into law the Medal of Honor. The first Medal of Honor recipients were six U.S. Army soldiers that were part of Andrews Raiders, and the medals were presented on March 25, 1863. Andrews Raiders were part of the Great Locomotive Chase. Today we're at the Coolidge National Medal of Honor Heritage Center in Chattanooga, Tennessee. The center features artifacts and displays of Medal Honor recipients from Tennessee and from locations in the state of Tennessee. You might ask yourself, why in Chattanooga, Tennessee? Well, it's because the Great Locomotive Chase ended very near to the city. 23 Union Army volunteers were led by civilian scout James Andrews. The Raiders made their way into northern Georgia and commandeered a train known as the General. They made their way north, causing as much damage to the railway line as they could. They were pursued by Confederate troops, and just 18 miles from Chattanooga, they abandoned their train. Andrews and all of his men were captured. Andrews and seven others were hanged as spies. The others either escaped from prison or were exchanged later in 1863 for Confederate POWs. These men received the first Medal of Honor on March 25, 1863. The eight executed men are now buried at the Chattanooga National Cemetery. Douglas MacArthur Jr., the father of famous World War II General Douglas MacArthur, would receive his Medal of Honor during the American Civil War at the Battle of Missionary Ridge during the Chattanooga Campaign. The 18-year-old lieutenant would lead his Wisconsin troops in a frontal assault on the hilltop, planting the regimental colors at the crest. There are many Civil War displays at the museum, including information about Mary Walker, the only woman to receive the Medal of Honor. George Jordan was a former slave from Tennessee who joined the United States Army as a Buffalo Soldier. During the Indian Wars, he received the Medal of Honor for his actions in New Mexico. There are a few World War I displays at the museum. One of the most famous soldiers from Tennessee is Alvin York, known as Sergeant York. His attack on German troops captured 35 machine guns, killed at least 25 enemy soldiers, and captured 132 prisoners. He is one of the most decorated U.S. Army soldiers of World War I. There are several World War II exhibits in the museum. These displays are informative and very well done. Charles Coolidge was from Tennessee and is the museum's namesake. Serving in the United States Army in France, Technical Sergeant Coolidge and his men fought off German attacks for 4 days on Hill 623 in France near the German border. For his actions, he received the Medal of Honor. Charles Coolidge is buried in the Chattanooga National Cemetery. Alexander Bonnieman Jr. moved to Knoxville, Tennessee with his family when he was a baby. Bonnieman joined the United States Marine Corps as a private shortly after the war had started. In February 1943, he received a battlefield commission to lieutenant. In November of 1943, Bonnieman would lead a group of Marines to attack a Japanese bunker on Tarawa. During the attack, Bonnieman would be killed in action. For his valor of leading the Marines, he would receive the Medal of Honor. Bonnieman was buried on Tarawa, and after the war, his remains were declared non-recoverable. In May of 2015, his grave was found on Tarawa, and he was returned home. He is buried in Knoxville at the Barry Highland Memorial Cemetery. Desmond Doss served in the United States Army as a combat medic. Due to his religious beliefs, he refused to carry a weapon. During the Battle of Okinawa, Corporal Doss saved an estimated 75 wounded men by lowering them down a cliff known as Hacksaw Ridge. Desmond Doss received the Medal of Honor for his actions on Okinawa. He was the first conscientious objector to receive the medal. He is buried at Chattanooga National Cemetery. Paul Huff was born in Tennessee and joined the United States Army. Huff became a paratrooper, and while manning a position on the Anzio beachhead, he and his men came under German artillery fire. While out on patrol, Huff on his own moved forward under fire, destroying a German machine gun nest, and later patrols, he killed 27 enemy soldiers and captured another 21 POWs. For his actions, he received the Medal of Honor. The museum has exhibits that cover Vietnam, Iraq, Afghanistan, and the War on Terror. There is much more to see at this museum that we could put in this video. If you are in the Chattanooga area, the Coolidge National Medal of Honor Heritage Center is a must visit. I hope you enjoyed that episode of History Adventures. Please like and comment on our video, and if you can, please subscribe to our page. We truly appreciate it. And please share with everyone you know that's a history buff. Thanks a lot. We'll see you next episode.